Hello and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Jay and I am so excited to have you join me. In today's video, I decided to kick it off by sharing my second breakfast, which I believe I shared already, but let's pretend like I didn't. What I eat is typically boring, let's be honest, but it works for me. It's yummy and I keep making it over and over and over. I don't get bored of it, which is surprising, but yes, what that consisted of, my second breakfast, was two pieces of sourdough toast. Sourdough toast is typically gonna be better than white bread because you're dealing with that fermentation, almost like kombucha in a way too. Again, you're dealing with that fermentation, which leads to the live culture, which is ultimately good for your gut health. So sourdough toast, extremely yummy. And I just paired that with some strawberry jam. And then we have spinach. Spinach is ultimately a scam, of course, but it is a vegetable. And I did make a lot of spinach. Prior to it cooking, we all know how it boils down, and that's ultimately what we dealt with there. And then we also had three fried eggs to get our protein in, but that's gonna be my second breakfast. And then for my first breakfast, which is what I had prior to going to the gym, which was oatmeal and blueberries. But overall, let's get into the content of what this video is about. For today's video, I wanted to show you guys how exactly I self-care. And self-care is very different from self-maintenance. And I definitely know that we get the two confused and we blend them together in today's society. Self-maintenance is gonna consist of things such as taking a bubble bath, drinking wine, getting your nails done, all of these things that contribute to your physical state of being. Whereas self-care is basically turning internally to evaluate things that may have you feeling frustrated, angry, whatever it is, getting down to the crumbs of why exactly you feel a certain way that you typically would not be feeling. And yes, so self-care, self-maintenance, very two different things that I think is important for us all to know. So I am more on the side of self-care, actual self-care, and not self-maintenance. I do things such as exfoliating, face mask, all of that stuff, but I don't really think of it as self-care because I'm not taking care of my mental state of being when I'm doing those things. I'm just thinking about having clear skin, getting my skin together, all of that stuff, which is typically what everyone else is thinking about when they're doing those things. And let's be honest, self-maintenance can get kind of expensive. Actually, it can get really expensive, let's be honest, which is why I think self-care needs to come back in and come back to what it actually is to take care of yourself mentally and to just check yourself at the end of the day or at the end of a long week and all of this stuff. I wanted to share the three things that I do for self-care before I get into the rhythm of things. The first one is journaling. Journaling is good for obvious reasons, especially for someone like me who I'm very detached from my emotions naturally. I hate vulnerability. So much better at it now because I choose to work on these things to be a better person. But some days I will admit I stay to myself and I choose to express myself within my journal. And I used to be the person who made fun of others who wrote in their diaries when they were little and all of that stuff, but it's very beneficial. Second thing is reading. I love reading self-development books. The current one that I'm reading is What Happened to You by Dr. Bruce D. Perry and Oprah. And it's extremely good. I'm reading it for the second time. And basically when someone's acting out, when someone's bad behaved or just acting in a negative manner, instead of chastising them, sit them down and ask them what happened to you. And I know within my own personal experience and all the trauma that I dealt with in my life, it took someone to sit down with me and ask me what happened to you to understand why exactly I was acting out in that way and get down to the grits of what exactly it was that was going on in my life to make me act out in this way. So, What Happened to You by Dr. Bruce D. Perry and Oprah. Extremely good book, reading it for the second time. The third thing is meditating. I didn't start meditating until probably about 3 months ago. Should have started earlier because it's so relaxing and just creates the safe safe space within your own mind that you create on your own. And it's so good for so many reasons. But again, I've only been doing it for 3 months and I'm kind of bad at it. I will say I only meditate probably for about 5 to 10 minutes, which I feel like I should do more. But it's okay, I'm just meditating, and I actually have a guided meditation book, which I will show you guys, that is guided meditation for anxiety. And I didn't start dealing with anxiety until probably about a year ago when I was working at a job I really hated. And it just, I don't know, reading through the book just helped me lots of times. I didn't actually start putting meditating into motion until probably about 3 months ago. So we have journaling, reading, and meditating. Let's get into the video. That is going to be all for today's video. I enjoy doing all of those three things whenever I self-care. Just to be realistic with you guys, I only self-care once a week. So Saturdays are my ideal days to do those things. And basically, I just work. I'm human. I have a busy life. But I also want to remain on top of my mental health just because, like you guys, I struggle with stuff also. And yeah, I just want to be sure that I'm taking that time for myself. When it comes to journaling, I like to literally word spit everything that's on my mind onto paper. So get in tune with all the negatives that I have on my mind, because most likely it's something that was frustrating me throughout the week. And then just because I started off so very negative, I always end with a gratitude list. So being sure to give thanks to the things in my life that I am grateful for. When it comes to reading, which was the second thing that I enjoy doing, I love reading self-development books, but you do not have to read a self-development book whatsoever. Just read something that you love. It could be something as simple as a poem, a haiku. Yeah, just do something that makes you feel good. Read something that makes you feel good. For the third thing, when it comes to meditating, honestly, I struggle getting in the zone, which is why meditating is so difficult for me. And in my mind, it's literally like a racetrack. And there's just lots of things going on in my mind. So it takes me a while to actually get in the zone. But once I do, it's great. So again, journaling, reading, and meditating. Those three things take me about 20 to 30 minutes. And I can guarantee you have 20 to 30 minutes to spare just to do those things. And also, like I said, I only do them once a week. So again, I'm sure we all have busy lives, just like I said. But again, even though you have a busy life does not mean you don't have time to sit down and be vulnerable with yourself. I also made my favorite cup of tea, which is Earl Grey. If you guys saw, I took a break before I went into meditating just because I needed something to quench my thirst, basically. And I did not just want water. So I just made Earl Grey tea. So just do whatever you need to do to get you in the zone, to get you close to your vulnerability and just being vulnerable with yourself. That is all for the video. I do want to thank you guys for being here. If you enjoyed watching this video, please be sure to subscribe, like, and comment. Thank you.